Hi. Generators, iterators, iterables, what are these things? Generators and iterators both are beneficial to use. However, both are very underestimated and underused by developers. I'm gonna cover them, the concept and coding example with PHP in this video. First, let's see what's an iterator. It's a design pattern. An iterator is used to traverse a container and access the container's elements. For an easy way to describe it, an iterator contains a list of data and provides an ability to loop on them. Any object follows this concept called iterable, and we can use it within a for each. For example, arrays are iterable. PHP has a built-in interface to build custom iterators, and it should to have these methods: current to return the element associated with the current key to return the current key or the current position. Next, we move the current key to point to the next element. Rewind will reset the key, and valid, which will validate the current position of the key. This interface extends from the traversable. It's the base interface for all traversable classes, and it's empty. Also, an iterable is a pseudo type introduced in PHP 7.1, and it can be passed as an argument. So let's have an example. I have an array here with some elements inside, with a loop to print the elements. Arrays are iterable, so in the procedural way, we can use the current function to get the current element, which is the element the current key is pointing to. This function will validate the current key too. It would return false if the current key did not point to any value. This happens after the key reaches to the latest element. Process it. To move to the next one. Works fine. To have it as an iterator object, we need to have an implementation from the iterator interface. This is a custom class. I need to have a couple of properties. Want to have a pointer as the key, position, an integer in case, but you can use a string or even a bool. And the second property I need is an array to put the elements inside. This is the initiation for array. I can initiate it as a parameter. Then I can pass an array. So let's add related methods. Parent. To return the current element, key, to return the position, next, to move the position one forward. Rewind to reset the position. And valid to validate the current position. Okay, let's declare it. I like to have one more method to add new elements. Due to the new initializers in the construct, I can put an array. And a forEach, we can read elements via a while too. What about to make some changes? Now it's better. Works fine. We have this class as an iterator, just like an array with some more functionalities. In another example, we can just use the array iterator. It's one of the built-in iterators in PHP. In this case, we don't really have to implement a custom class. To do it in the iterator's way, simply we can pass it into array iterator. For array iterator, the current method not gonna check for the validity of the current key. So let's have it like this. Fine. This code is a little bit different than the last example due to the current method which not gonna check for the validity. So I have checked it directly. Also it has the seek method and append and some other helpful methods too. Fine. There are some other built-in iterators in PHP too, which can be very helpful to avoid implementing everything. Alright, now why iterators? Arrays may be insufficient for the job in some cases. Iterators make it possible to iterate anything more complex than a simple array. Any data provider can be used through the iterator interface to run within a simple forEach. Encapsulation and abstraction to hide the data and the code complexity inside of the object. And it may have efficient memory usage in some cases. So let's talk about the generators. What are generators? As the PHP.NET says, generators provide an easy way to implement simple iterators without the overhead or complexity of implementing a class that implements the iterator interface. A generator allows you to write code that uses forEach to iterate over set of data without holding an array in memory, which may cause to exceed the memory limit or require a considerable amount of processing time to generate. So, what is really a generator? Let's have the same example. Everything looks fine, but what if, for example, to have 5 big images to load instead of 5 strings? Do we need to load them all first? What about a big array? What if this array contains a dozen or a million of elements instead of just 5? In a search scenario, it's enough the current element appears. In that case, the rest of the array may not be needed. We know this loop passes only one item at a time, and this function also will process only one item at a time too. There is no parallel process here, but the array loads first. Then we have the array with the data inside. It could contain a large number of elements in the memory during the whole execution time of the script. This may cause high memory usage or exceed the memory limit. In other case, it may cause to have more load time or a high CPU usage. So this is a problem. We don't need the whole array during the execution time. One element at a time is what we need. And this is why we have the generators. The generator, which is implemented from the iterator interface, has been added to PHP in PHP 5.5 to help to prevent memory overload. We have the yield instead of the return in generators, and you're not gonna instantiate it via the new keyword due to the behavior of the yield. Yield works like the return without breaking the function to keep going with the iterable after an element is returned. We have the same output. If I dump it, this object should be empty. because it's a generator with the behavior of an iterable. In this example, to have the array like a generator, I can write a function, make my items, f4, yield item I. From 1 until 5, the output is fine. The same thing here if I dump it. It's empty. Then let's say we have a million elements to test the execution time and RAM usage. One another example, because I'm not going to fill a million elements manually. I'm gonna use this example provided by php.net. This function works just like the range function, but it's working by the yield as a generator instead of the return. With the XRange, which works in generator's way, I have about 40 milliseconds for execution time with less than a half megabyte of memory peak. For the range, 20 milliseconds long for execution time, which is lower than the XRange. However, for memory peak, 32.4 megabytes, which is much higher. Or for 100 million, not a billion because it's gonna exceed my memory limit, yeah, 4 gigabytes. And 1.8 second execution time for the range function. For the XRange, is still the same as before, less than a half of megabyte, but the execution time is 2 times higher. With the generators, we have much low memory usage but higher CPU usage. Generators are useful, they may not be used widely, but you can find them used in frameworks and libraries. For example, Laravel lazy collection is based on the generators, and the same concept with the lazy loading. There are more tips about the generators and especially the iterators. I tried to make this video short and I hope it will be enough to get started with the generators, iterators and iterables. For ideas, feel free to drop a comment below and tell me what do you think. If you find this video useful or you're interested, please press the like button to support me and subscribe to get notified of my next videos. Thank you for watching, see you in the next video.